Hello and welcome to my next video. The idea I have come up with will make curses more useful, Dagon of Kings more profitable, and add a substitute for the Dragon Warhammer. If you like that, you should continue to watch. But first, we need to do some groundwork with curses. Curses are located in the normal spellbook. There are 6 different curses, 3 low-level ones and 3 high-level ones. And respectively, they lower attack, strength and defense by 5% for the low-level ones and 10% for the high-level spells. My idea is to buff the high-level ones, so let's ignore the low-level ones. The buff will be done by a staff. Its effect is rather simple. Instead of 10% lowered stats, it will lower them by 30%. You should grasp now why this would be a substitute to the Dragon Warhammer. Because vulnerability, the high level defense curse, would be as effective as the Dragon Warhammer. So, would it replace the Dragon Warhammer? It wouldn't. Because curses have a unique mechanic to them. If you have hit your target with a curse, you can't cast the curse a second time onto the target. But you can use 2 Dragon Warhammer specs onto a target. So, in a sense, it would be a slightly worse ranged Dragon Warhammer. Good. If the item makes it in the game, you could combine the two. Imagine a monster being hit with 1 enhanced vulnerability and 2 Dragon Warhammer specs. That would be a lot of damage. Now that we have established how strong this new stuff will be, let us talk about the costs. Because it's obviously a strong addition to the game, some extra costs are necessary. And the first is an increased consumption of soul runes. Because the enhanced spell is 3 times stronger, it should cost 3 times more than the original. So, 3 soul runes instead of 1. This would also be an item sink for soul runes, just as a byproduct. The next fee has to do with the curses themselves. They cost earth and water runes, all of them. So it would be nice if my idea staff could supply these as well. And here enters the profitability improvement to the Dagon of Kings. Prime drops a mud battle staff. And I would use this battle staff to charge my idea staff, so it could supply earth and water runes. But how many charges should one staff give? I would go with 10,000. Why? It's a nice round number. And if you divide the current price for 1 mud battle staff by 10,000, the result would be 3 GP per cast. Low, I know, but if this update comes to the game, it will not stay the same. The price for the mud battle staff will go up, and the price might increase to some hundred thousands or even a million GP. And why that is, I will explain right now. The Dragon Warhammer has a cap for how often you can use it based on your spec bar. This new staff wouldn't have this restriction, because you can cast spells if you have the runes. Good, you can't curse someone 2 times in a row, but a decrease of defense by 30% for every NPC you want to fight, that's tremendous. And now imagine this at Rune Dragons or Zulra. Yes, you would be able to lower the defense of Zulra, because this is a spell and not a melee weapon. So what can we extract from this? Players, if they have the staff, will use the staff on every Zulra, Warcraft or Rune Dragon kill. So we can be sure that these charges will melt away. And if things are in demand, they will rise in price. So, I would conclude that my estimation for the mud staff's price should be correct. And if the mud battle staff would hit a value of 1 million GP, it would add a cost of 100 coins per cast to the spell. And if you add that now to the cost for the 3 soul runes, the result would be 550 GP per cast. But this estimation would include no price changes for soul runes. And in my estimation, they should rise in price as well. We have now spoken about the impact of the stuff. Let us now talk about the stats of the stuff. Because we have not done this yet. In order to make the stuff viable in several different situations, it should have a high accuracy bonus. But no damage bonus, because it should buff curses and not damage spells. Now back to the accuracy. I would go with 30 or even up to 45. After all, these curses should hit. And now at last, something to think about. Maybe there should also be a third effect. This effect would triple the current overall mage accuracy, so it is guaranteed to hit, even in full melee equipment. But this is far more debatable than the other two effects, which are the enhanced curses and the supplied earth and water runes. Also, the staff should be able to auto-cast curses, just to make it coherent. This is my idea. If you liked it, you can like the video and subscribe for more idea videos. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.